Every parent's situation is different. Some may have trouble conceiving, and some may be playing the role of both parents to their kids. I had a candid chat with the gorgeous Pooja Bedi, who opened up about being a single mom to her two gorgeous kids. First things first, being a mummy show and a parenting show, what does motherhood mean to you, and how did you change as a person when you became a mom?
You know, firstly, I have to say that I think ever since the age of 16, I have wanted to be a mother. Then, of course, there's the issue of let's find the right person to be a father. You know, and am I the right stage of my life to get married?
Right.
And you have all these practical things that you need to sort out before you can actually get on with the business of having kids.
Right.
You know, because it has to all be very well thought of. For me, everything in life, be it marriage, be it children, has to be a very well-planned experience.
Yes.
You realize once your kids are born that they don't come with manuals,
yeah.
You know, how to operate manuals. Because at the end of the day, every kid is so unique.
Absolutely.
And every kid has their own incredible personality. I mean, my two kids couldn't be more polar.
Really?
As individuals, and yet they've eaten the same food, they stayed in the same room, they've had the same holidays, they
yeah.
have the same family,
yeah.
they have the same experiences, they go to the same school,
yeah.
and they're just so different. My daughter is really vibrant and extroverted and, you know, and arty and all of that. My son is really sort of introverted, and he's very, he's a thinker, he loves to play football. I look at the two of them and I go, wow,
yeah.
how does that happen? Like, how can you rear two plants in the same pot and have them of the same variety, you know, and then just see them bloom into totally two different creations.
Well,
I have to share
to
something
that.
Really sweet with you, which is, you know, I got divorced and then I'm the single parent. And when you're a single parent, there's so much you have to juggle. It's like you want to be Ma Durga and you need 10 hands to
right.
handle everything. You're a nurturer. You're
yeah.
a provider. You're playing the role of the mother and of the father.
Yeah.
You're a memsahib. I'm a pet owner. You have two beautiful kids. So you're mommy in, you know, 24/7 mode. You know, you're a working person. You have a social life. You have friends. You need to network. You need to work out. You know, there's just so much you need to do on a daily basis.
Yes.
And it's overwhelming. So I remember I came home and something happened to the kids' homework. Or one remark was made saying that homework not submitted on time. And I looked at them and I said, kids, you have to understand one thing. Mama works very, 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 very hard. And I'm doing so many different things. And I said, I don't expect you to do my work. So please don't expect me to do your work. I don't expect you to pester me to do my job. Please don't make me pester you to do what's your responsibility.
Yeah.
And they just looked at me. And ever since that day, I've never had to say, do your homework. I've never had a remark. They're brilliant students. I mean, I'm so proud of my kids because though I've been there for them and I've been this really active, involved mother, the fact is they've actually done it by themselves,
yes.
at least academically.
Yeah.
You know, it's their achievements and I'm so proud of them.
So how did you actually tell them about you and Farhan separating?
Having been the product of a couple that was divorced, I saw that the best way to actually go about it was the way my mother handled it. She didn't make anything an issue.
Right.
Everything was very easy and fluid and beautiful. Papa was wonderful. She was wonderful. The divorce was wonderful. We never felt that we were abandoned or neglected, etc., etc. The same with my kids. They were very tiny. Omar was 2 years old and Alia was 5. Weekdays, they were with me. Weekends, they would go to Farhan. Made sure it was a very amicable space between all of us. Farhan and me divorced each other. That doesn't mean we divorced the children.
Yeah.
They will always be, we will all together always be a family. There was just one time when Alia asked me, she said, Mama, everyone's papa stay with them. How come our papa doesn't stay with us? And I looked at her and I said, Alia, you know, when papa was here, there was so much like fighting and nonsense and all going on in the house. She said, yeah, mama, my ears used to pain.
Mm-hmm.
I said, see, I said, now mama is so happy and papa is so happy. And you're here with mama. It's all happy, happy. When you go to papa's home, it's all so happy, happy.
Mm-hmm.
So for them, it was a question of everything is happy, happy.
Yeah.
So there was nothing to be worried about or concerned about or, you know, feel upset about.
And that's amazing because I think a lot of times people stay together, as they say, for the children. But actually, it can go horribly wrong if you do that. And it's not
yes.
actually a happy, happy environment and you're forcing
yeah,
it.
The situation is twofold. One is you compromise your own self and you compromise your own life. You compromise your own happiness. Yes, sometimes we marry with the best intentions and we have the sense of it has to last forever. We all want a fairy tale.
Yeah.
We all want that knight on a horse who will come galloping in, sweep you off your feet and this whole concept of the happily ever after.
Yeah.
But sometimes it's not meant to be.
Yeah.
And do you turn around and say, because I had 12 good years, now things have changed. It's come to a point, it's irreparable.
Yeah.
So do I want 50 bad years or do I want to say, thank you for the 12 good years, but I'd really like the rest of my life to be equally fantastic.
Absolutely.
I don't want to compromise it. I don't want my kids growing up thinking it's normal for parents to fight, to be bitter, to sleep in separate rooms, to have that space. That's not normal.
Absolutely.
I don't want them seeing a situation like that thinking that is what marriage is. That is not what marriage is or should ever be.
Yeah.
And the beautiful part is my kids have grown up so well-rounded, so wholesome. They're such happy people.
And do you think they believe in the fairy tale?
I certainly hope everybody on this planet believes in this perfect fairy tale, because I believe sometimes it is possible. Sometimes maybe not with number one or even number two. Maybe you have to get to number three. Who knows?
Have you found number three?
No, I haven't found number two also. Where's number three?
Number two. No, but so do you date? I mean, you do date, right?
Yeah,
so,
I mean, I'm human.
Of course. So when did you start? When did you start dating again?
It took a bit of time because I think one is naturally apprehensive. Also, there's a sense of responsibility. If you have children, you're adapting to a whole new environment around you.
Yeah.
You've got to this space where you're in charge of every single thing in your orbit. It all depends on you. And also, there's this incredible emotional responsibility you feel for your children. And you just want to make sure they're okay first.
Yes.
Because you don't want them to be victimized by your decisions. You
Absolutely.
Don't want them to bear the brunt of it.
Yeah.
So I think I really enjoyed my kids at that point of time. Of course, I had to get back to earning. I didn't take a rupee in alimony. So that was really scary for me.
Wow.
And panicking because before marriage, I had a fantastic lifestyle. I was affording for myself through movies and theater and modeling and all of that. And, during marriage, my husband made me give up my career to help him build his. And there you are, you're divorced, you have no alimony because court systems in India, as you know, they're terrible. Yeah, you can fight it out for 10 years or 15 years and have a terrible relationship with the man while you're fighting. You can say, you know what, okay, you don't want to give anything, that's fine, but at least be a great dad to the kids,
right.
And
so you literally, honestly, financially had to
start from scratch in your 30s,
wow.
And you're terrified because it is scary,
Of course, I'm sure.
And this industry is all I've ever known. And it's so amazing. I started writing the column. I started my talk show and I never looked back and, afforded a fantastic lifestyle for myself.
That's amazing. Super commendable. When you actually separated from Farhan, how difficult was it for you? The kids we've talked about and how you managed telling them and stuff. But
what did you feel?
Like, how did you deal with
that? Beyond the fact that I felt like I needed to multitask all my different roles. And then there's the fact that you have to balance having kids and having that work life, which is integral to who you want to be in your life, give you a personal sense of satisfaction, and also the income. You need the income.
Yeah.
Yes, the hours are very demanding in this profession. And yes, I think my kids have been extremely patient and lenient with me in that aspect. They haven't been clingy kids. They were happy I went because it meant mama's earning money. If mama earns money, mama can buy us fun things. You know, we get nice clothes, we get nice toys, we get nice outings, we get nice experiences. So mama going out to work meant that their lives were, and our lives together were fuller in every possible way. So you have to let them know there has to be a dialogue between parent and child. You cannot let them seem like it's a terrible tragedy that's come upon you to be a single parent, because then that becomes a reality.
But how did you feel emotionally in terms of, were you very alone, or do you feel that you had the infrastructure and the help and great friends and support system to get you through?
It was actually very tiring physically. It's very demanding on you emotionally, mentally, physically, spiritually, in every possible way to be a single parent. But in the end, there's this focus that says, why do I choose to leave? I choose to leave because I'm unhappy. So if I'm going to leave space of unhappiness and then still be unhappy, I should have stayed.
Right.
So the idea of leaving that is to be happy. So you work actively on what it takes, whatever it takes, to make you happy.
So what would be a mummy quote, as you are a fountain of amazing quotes? What would you like to say to the mummies out there who find you very inspirational?
You know, what I'd really like to tell every mother out there is, I know sometimes we get into this rut of motherhood, but motherhood should never be a rut. Please have fun with your kids. We as parents forget this whole concept of fun. I can't emphasize enough to mothers out there the importance of physical touch. Have a child in your arms while you're reading them a book. Even if you're watching TV, hug them, kiss them, throw one leg over them. Have some contact with your children. They've come from you. They've come through you. You know, just don't lose that connection, that physical connection, that emotional connection, that spiritual connection. Don't make it mundane. Please don't get into the rut of mummyhood. Enjoy it.
Thank you so much for coming on the show.
It's been a pleasure.
Do write in to me on our social media handles. And for latest updates, do log on to our website. Till we meet again. Bye-bye.